Hi, it's Katrina. Number 10, Earth 2.0. For the first time ever, we may have found a planet just like Earth. The Transiting Exoplanet Survey satellite, codenamed TESS, has discovered the first planet ever that's the perfect distance from its star to support life, and is about the same size as Earth. It might even have water. NASA hasn't actually detected liquid water, but the conditions suggest it is a possibility. The planet is being called TOI-700d, and it's one of only a handful of planets the same size as our own within a particular star's habitable zone. The other planets like this that we know about have all been discovered by the Kepler Space Telescope. But TESS is a little bit different. It launched specifically to search for potentially habitable planets just like Earth. It does this by monitoring a large part of the sky known as a sector for 27 days before moving on to the next. This incredibly long stare allows the satellite to track all changes in brightness that would be caused by a planet orbiting its star. As for TOI-700d, it's only about 100 light-years from us, located in the southern constellation Dorado. Its star is about 40% the size and mass of the Sun, and only half its surface temperature. This means it's significantly smaller and colder than our own star. But because of the proximity of Earth 2.0 to this mystery star, the situation is perfect for breeding habitable life. The big problem is that we have no possible way of knowing if any life is thriving. But if the planet has a similar temperature to our own and liquid water, it would be a perfect candidate for our first intergalactic colony. What do you think? Are you ready for it? Let me know in the comments below. Number 9. Liquid on Titan. On the largest moon of Saturn, Titan, scientists have detected giant canyons flooded with liquid hydrocarbons. The information comes to us thanks to data received from NASA's Cassini spacecraft. The spacecraft took some amazing photographs of very deep canyons on the surface of the moon, which researchers are now confident in saying are dark channels spreading out from the Ligeia Mare Sea, totally filled with liquid. This discovery was the first time that scientists were able to put forth real evidence that Titan has liquid-filled canyons. But of course, this isn't liquid water. For those who don't know, Titan is a frigid and very cold moon, the second biggest in the solar system, with large bodies of liquid methane. The moon is completely crusted over with hydrocarbon ice, and it has lakes and rivers of both liquid methane and ethane. It also has a thick atmosphere that scientists believe is a prime example of what the conditions were like when our solar system was first created. It's true that scientists already knew about Titan's methane seas, but they hadn't known about the canyons. NASA says they believe the canyons may have formed just like the Grand Canyon here on Earth, from thousands and thousands of years of a flowing river carving them out. These canyons are almost 2,000 feet deep in some places, and they are filled to the brim with black liquid methane. Oh yeah, and the surface temperature here is about -289°F. Number 8. Emissions from an alien world. Scientists believe they may have potentially detected radio emissions coming from an alien planet beyond our system for the first time in history. The astronomers behind the detection used a radio telescope in the Netherlands to study a trio of stars that host exoplanets. The researchers noticed that one star system really stood out from all the others, called Tau Boots. The radio signal they picked up was so strong and so polarized that they believe it must have come from a planet's magnetic field. This is according to Jake Turner from Cornell University, the lead author of this new and exciting research. This planet is about 51 light-years from Earth in the constellation Boots. And if you're wondering how an alien planet is able to emit signals that we can pick up here on Earth, it all goes back to Jupiter. These researchers first studied the kinds of emissions that were coming off Jupiter's surface. They then tweaked their measurements to reflect a greater distance from Earth and pointed the radio receiver deeper into the universe. It really all comes down to how powerful a planet's magnetic field is. This is just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to detecting alien planets. Once scientists perfect the art of picking up radio emissions, they'll be able to see planets with magnetic fields very far from us. They'll also be able to tell a lot about the planet's history based on its magnetic field. Number 7. The hum of plasma waves. As of right now, the Voyager 1 spacecraft is somewhere around 14.1 billion miles from the planet Earth, of course. It's moving at an outstanding speed of 38,000 miles per hour. And not too long ago, it passed across the boundary of our solar system and entered into the true gulf of space. And yet, despite this immense distance, Voyager 1 is still sending information back to us. And yes, it is still making new discoveries. One of these discoveries came to us in the form of a sound. Hearing a sound in space doesn't really make a lot of sense for one main reason. There is no sound in space. Sound cannot flow through an empty vacuum. It needs air to travel, or at least something that can act as a medium for the sound waves to pass through. Scientists believe the sound managed to reach Voyager 1 by traveling through space on invisible gases. The actual sound was the hum of plasma waves moving through space. These plasma waves were created by our very own sun. According to the NASA researchers, a solar wind carried gas billions of miles away from the sun when it expelled a burst of plasma. It was probably the result of a solar storm on the star's surface, when plasma spiked and a small burst of it got shot into space. Over 14 billion miles away, Voyager 1 actually picked up the sound of our sun basically belching. Number 6. Ice volcanoes. NASA has made yet another outstanding discovery on the dwarf planet Ceres, this time in the form of icy volcanoes. Ceres never did get big enough to become an actual planet, instead getting the less popular title of dwarf planet. But even though this little piece of rock isn't technically a planet, it still has some pretty impressive geological features. Observations from NASA's Dawn spacecraft have shown that the little planet could be harboring cryovolcanoes at the bottom of some of its craters. Now, keep in mind that Ceres is located between Mars and Jupiter. It's a piece of rock mostly covered in ice, and a lot of this ice may actually be building up underground, just like lava builds up under volcanoes here on Earth. The cameras on the Dawn spacecraft showed physical flowing material just like lava at the bottom of the craters, except less viscous and tinged blue. It's the same color as material found at the top of a mountain on Ceres that scientists believe once erupted with a mixture of ice and mud. The theory now is that the flowing material is of a similar mixture inside the craters. It's ice mixed with mud and salt, and scientists say it could be erupting out of the weakest points on the dwarf planet's surface. To make things simple, it's ice volcanoes. Ceres literally has volcanoes erupting out icy mud instead of lava. Which do you prefer? Let me know in the comments below. Number 5. The Mars bug. A scientist from Ohio has made a wild claim that there are insects on Mars. He's based this claim on supposed photographic proof from various NASA Mars rovers throughout the years. His name is William Ramoser, and he isn't actually a crackpot. He's a professor and a specialist in the study of viruses transmitted by arthropods at Ohio University. His evidence is pretty shaky, really only coming from his own interpretation of the photographs, meaning that it can only be considered theory and isn't currently verifiable. He presented his bizarre findings at a national meeting held by the Entomological Society of America. He showed photographs taken from the Mars rovers that seemed to show tiny insects with legs, abdomens, heads, and all the other insect parts. And he claims there is diversity as well, with a lot of different kinds of bugs on the red planet. But according to other scientists, he's completely delusional. Pretty much everybody except him says that he's finding insects where there aren't any. He's looking at rocks and interpreting them as insect fossils. He's doing this in the same way that one might look at a cloud and interpret a dragon. Either that, or he's completely right and everybody else is just trying to cover up the fact that there are indeed insects on Mars. What do you think? Are there really insects on Mars, or is this guy just practicing some wishful thinking? Let me know your theories in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. We have lots more videos coming up. Number 4. Merging black holes. Scientists have discovered a collision between two supermassive black holes. It's one of the most catastrophic and destructive things that scientists have ever seen out in the universe. The pair of supermassive black holes are the nearest ever discovered to our planet. Astronomers say they are currently merging into a single monstrosity of unbelievable proportions. It's happening about 89 million light-years away from us in a galaxy called NGC 7727. Scientists have been measuring the mass of each of the black holes by watching how gravity affects the movement of the nearby stars. Observations with the European Southern Observatory's Very Large Telescope have shown the two giant black holes are only 1,600 light-years away from each other. In cosmic distance, they are basically breathing in each other's faces. This small separation between the black holes suggests that they will merge into one giant, massively supermassive black hole within the next 250 million years. This is what Holger Baumgart says, a professor at the University of Queensland, Australia. And to give you an idea of just how powerful these celestial objects are, the bigger of the two contains the mass of 154 million suns. The smaller one only contains the mass of 6.3 million suns. But still, the power of these celestial bodies is completely insane. They aren't a danger to us, but you definitely wouldn't want to fly your starship anywhere near them. Number 3. Dark matter stars. There is a possibility that stars composed totally of dark matter once populated the universe. This isn't a true discovery, more of a theory, but one that's quite interesting anyway. Scientists say that when the Big Bang first happened, the universe was much smaller than it is today. In the smaller environment, dark matter came into existence, and it was then that scientists believe that dark stars may have been born. But here's the twist. Dark matter stars wouldn't have actually been dark. Instead, they would have been the biggest and brightest objects in the universe. No one has ever seen one with their eyes. At least no human ever has. But we are currently looking. And if you're a bit confused about dark matter, so is everybody else. Scientists say that at least 26% of the universe is made of dark matter, and that thousands of these particles pass through your body every second. It's just impossible to detect and study because dark matter is intangible. It emits no light, and it only leaves a gravitational fingerprint behind. In the case of dark matter stars, huge collections of this material began to cluster in patches, eventually forming the first stars in the universe right after the Big Bang, kickstarting the formation of normal stars and then galaxies. But as the universe continually expanded, dark stars became irrelevant, died, and probably went extinct. Number 2. Water worlds. In a shocking new study, researchers are suggesting that there are exoplanets outside our solar system that are completely covered in water. These are water worlds, with oceans deeper than anything we have ever seen before. And by deeper than anything, I'm talking hundreds or even thousands of miles or kilometers deep. The study was done by astronomer Li Zeng of Harvard University and his colleagues. Zeng explained that based on his team's computer simulations, Earth's oceans are basically puddles compared to what's lurking out there on planets outside our solar system. For example, the maximum depth of the ocean on Earth is at the bottom of the Mariana Trench, about 6.8 miles. But there are water worlds out there that are 2 or even 4 times larger than Earth with global oceans. These planets likely formed much further away from their host stars than they are today as giant balls of ice. But as they drifted closer to their stars and got warmer, that ice melted and their gravity was increased, causing the surface ice to turn to water and create oceans thousands of miles deep. And where there's water, there is almost always life. Just imagine a planet with an ocean 1,000 times larger than any we have, and the life forms that must be lurking within it. Number 1. Weird moon substance. Chinese scientists found a weird substance on the far side of the moon. It happened last year, with their U-2 rover stumbling across a curious substance that nobody could immediately identify. At first, The discovery sparked intense interest among lunar scientists because it didn't look like anything seen on the moon before. However, after a year of analyzing what appeared to be some kind of gel, scientists say the substance is actually made up of rock. They used a process called spectral unmixing to see what the most likely composition of the substance was. According to the researchers, the material is dark green, it glistens, and there is a pile of it about 20 inches long. They found the presence of glass, suggesting it was created during an impact event. There was some kind of impact that caused minerals to cement together and form a black, glossy, glass-like material. It never ended up being mysterious space goo like so many people thought at first, just the leftover rock residue of some past event that generated serious heat. It could have been from a space rock crashing into the moon. It could have even potentially been from some kind of ship taking off, with its thruster melting the surface rock into a type of craggy glass. Thanks for watching! What's the craziest thing you think is hiding out in space? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. See you next time. Bye!